Hallelujah. We bow in the presence of our mighty Melech. He is the King of splendor. He is the King of excellence. He is the mighty one of Yisrael. There is none like him. There is none that even share the similarities to Almighty Yah. There is no man that has walked in the dynamics of Yah's Torah like Yahshua HaMashiach. And he came to impart that power in the bosom of Yisrael, that you began to understand the revelation of whom I am. You can do all things that the Torah commands you. But because we don't know who he is, we can't do anything that the Torah commands us. And so what we're trying to do is reason in our own proclivity, our ability to dissect, to dismantle, to deduct, or receive from it by the limitations of our own mind how it process what we hear and what we read. And it's almost like a man that is illiterate, having no ability to read, but yet he is trying to instruct one in the finite details of an assembly whereby he doesn't even know part A from part Z, because he has no ability in his own sense to reason by deducting from what the instruction says as to what is part A and what is part Z. And so this is the generation that we're in. It's a foolish generation. The wicked, the foolish man, the man of no knowledge of Yah, he has said no unto Almighty Yah. He has said no, no. Or in essence, there is no great one, no mighty one, and there is no Abba. So they're going about in their own folly, their own foolishness, doing what is right in their own eyes. It is one thing, in our own eyes, all of our ways seem right. All the ways of a man, they are right in his own perception, in his own eyes. But it says that Yah, he ponders. No, he doesn't sit there and scratch his head and meditate. He ponders, or he weighs the balance of that man. He knows the balance of a man. And so every way that we perceive is right, and everything we base our knowledge of truth on that. Instead of dismantling a corrupt house and tearing it down and thrusting down the pillars of that to the gates of hell, that our minds will be made free. And what does one does? He goes from this one or she and corrupts everything that they touch, Yisrael. That's why we must come out of her, my people. We must not touch the unclean things of the world. This is an unclean time. Oh, the day that Yah has made the Shabbat, this is what they call Christmas Eve, but it's still right. Yom Rishon is his first day, it's still right. But the power of the beast, not just the beast, but the beast's spirit, and the demonic power, the shodim, the demons, the mind that has an assault, its intent is to dismantle Almighty Yah. And that's the sure sign of the mark in a man's forehead and in his right hand, his yad, is his strength. In his rush is where the power of the kingdom resides. For Almighty Yah is the head of Yahshua HaMashiach. Did not Zachariah Ramayah bring that out to us? Yahshua is the head of man. And man is the Rosh of the Isha. These are foolish women. They do not know that salvation always comes from the head. There are those that have said that I have instructing them to disobey their ish, the husband. They're damn liars. I don't care how faithful the woman is. I don't care how wicked her man is. Shut your damn mouth, woman. If it's your long to live with that man, shut your damn mouth. He does that. I don't give a damn what he does. You shut your damn mouth and express the beauty of your head. He will see. He will see. Shut your damn mouth, woman. But what do I do? He celebrates Christmas. Let him put up every damn tree he wants to. You simply say, baby, please, I don't want to do this. He's not going to mandate that. Well, if you don't do it, I'm not going to buy you anything. Okay, I love you so much. Thank you. Can the children and I go and I read them a story about Yeshua? Yeah, I don't care. And all of a sudden, he began to see. But if she rises up against that man, thinking that she's ahead, he will break her head. And he will defy because he's not going to allow her to command him. And that's why many women mess up today. There was this liar that said, I did everything you said. You're a damn liar, woman. You did what I said. Come on, you didn't do what I said. But there's one thing I want your hearts to rejoice in. I'm going to continue on the teaching today. On the mark, the reason in the forehead and the hand, the yad, the rush. But I want to say this. It's one thing that we must realize, Yisrael. As the old ones were singing the song, Yah has it all in control. I know what they would say, but believe me. He got this whole thing in the mastery of his hand. That's why you don't go out here and march against their Christmas sales. You don't do anything like that. You don't go in the house of your kinsmen and tear down. You don't mess with that. You simply do not participate in their activities. You don't go out there and do that, Yisrael. Let me read this before I continue. I read this on last night, but it's vital. I want to read it again. But we're going to continue in the path of the mark of the beast and man. I want to read this out of the book of Yeshua quickly. And what Yah does here, Yeshua chapter 66. He looks at the bosom of Yisrael, our levim, our hearts, our leba, our minds, and the strength of our being. Everything of us is controlled from the leb, the leba, the mind, the heart. This is the heart here. I know that we think that Yah is talking about this muscle that simply contracts and retracts to pump blood. That's the Pacific of this organ. It is the pump that carries blood, which supplies oxygen to every extremity of the body. That's all it does. That there is life in what we call the cellular structure of human beings, of mankind. That's all this does. It is just a pump. Pum, 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 pum. There is no emotions that derive from this pump. It derives from here. It derives from here. And when we see that in the Torah, the lib, the lev, the leba, the mind, it is all talking of the same element, Yisrael. It is basically the same thing. You do not have any emotions from here. It comes from here. This is the center of all things here. That glob of nothing but fatty tissue, nothing but cholesterol. That's the only thing that man can call it. It is just a glob of cholesterol, but yet that thing here is muscular. It has texture. It has fiber. This has nothing. Nothing at all. I have seen this die in an individual and this beat. Pum, 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 pum. I have seen the chicken with the head cut off and it flops 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 and it flops. I have cut the head off of a snake and yet the other part continued to move and move and move and move until the strength of that has dissipated. But this is the strength. This is the rush of man. He did not say that Yah is the heart of Yeshua. He's the Rosh. He's the Melech. He's the king. He's the ruling force in his mind. Yeshua should be the ruling force in the mind of man. And when you find a true Isha, a woman of Torah, it is the law of the lips of her Isha rules in her mind. She doesn't try to correct him. We as a woman, we cannot correct him. Yeah? She hears because he is the Yoshak, is the salvation of her home. He is the one that brings the salvation. He is the one that bears the swords. He is the one. And so with this vile feminist spirit today, many men today have been raised on the women preachers, what they call themselves. They've been a part of these whole houses where the women were preachers. The effeminate husband was the bishop, and his Jezebelite Jezebel wife was the pastor, what they will call them. And so a lot of women raised under this kind of duplicity, and although they think that they have eradicated themselves, so that they still hold fast to the tenets. Because the thing they learned under that erotic, corrupt spirit, they still utilize that as the pinnacle or the measure or the tool as to what they teach today, even though they may know the name of the Most High. But they're raised under Jezebel's spirit. It's one thing that God never allowed me to sit under any woman that she will rule over me. Never! 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 Even Mother Dorsey, she never called herself a leader. We were gathered there in a little old room, and she knew there was something in me, though. He's different. She knew that. Beautiful mother. She was just a simple missionary that would go from house and place to help, to assist. Beautiful, beautiful spirit. Heard her husband had been married all those years. She said to my Isha and I one day, she looked at us, she said, "Mac Dorsey has never seen me naked." That's what she said. Never. And that woman was 15 years older than that man. He was a beautiful man. He was a very beautiful man. Beautiful man. He has never. She wore nothing that did not reach to here. Nothing. She wore no dress that did not go down to the floor. She was a beautiful old mother. And Yah gave her the spiritual carefulness and care that she knew that it was something in that brother like none of the other ones that I knew. Are you boasting? Oh, don't be silly. I have nothing to boast in. What am I but a piece of flesh? All flesh is as grass. And my flesh shall go to corruption just like yours. It's going to stink. There will be no perfume odor in my flesh when it dies. It's going to rot, and the skin worms, the maggots, are going to eat it up just like your flesh. The maggots are going to consume it. I want to read this again that I read last night. Some of y'all were not listening, but you that were. I want to read this. It gives me comforting. Quickly, and I will go into the teachings today. In Yeshaya, let me begin at chapter 66. The book of Isaiah 66. Verse 1, as Yah began to examine Yisrael, our hearts, and shows us if there is a guilt, then there is vengeance. Be not deceived, Yah is not mocked. For whatsoever man sowed, that shall he also reap. We have sown, and we don't realize that we have laid out seed that was so corrupt, it has been rotten in the clods. And all of a sudden, the seed began to spring forth with fruit and strange fruit that we know not of. It's one thing that if you ever put something in my bosom, as a young man, he put it there, the things you have done, if you lost your finger in your sins, when I retrieve you from the dungeons of hell, it doesn't mean that a new finger is going to grow. You reap what you sow, Yisrael. We as a nation, we have sown much. If we eat sugary things all day at an undisciplined diet, do we reap that? Do we not to have the effects of that down the years, down the road in our bodies? Sure we do. I can attest to that. You may not can, but I can't speak to that. He says this to his beloved, his people. And Yisrael, we must understand we are the beloved of Yah. He loves us. I don't like using that word because it has been so distorted, maligned. It has been so mishandled, manipulated. But he is still a Chava. He is. He gives us this great assurance. And I want to go into the teaching. He says here in the book of Yeshaya 66 verse 1. Yeshaya says, this is what Yah declares. This says Yah. Yah says that How Shemayim is my throne, is my kese, it's where my kingdom is, the heavens that you see. I've given you a glimpse of it that you may understand the dynamics of my kingdom. Isn't the heavens beautiful? The heavens that we can't see. There's nothing like it. It is vast. It is massive. You cannot measure it with the measuring tool of man. Even in your imagination, you cannot measure it. And so he lets us know that this is my kese. This is my throne. No, we didn't hear that. He said, the heavens is my throne. A king sits on a throne. This is his throne here. I sit here, my throne. He is saying that Hashemiah and the heavens is my throne. Do you hear that? I don't think we heard that. He said, the heavens above is where I sit. And I spread my arms on my throne, my kese, the heavens. This is who, listen, this is who has us in his hands. But my trials, you know, man, he says that the heavens, heaven is my throne. This is what Yah says. And he said, the earth is my footstool. I don't care how long you live. There are those that have been to many nations, in many parts of the world, but they have not circumferenced the span and the scope of even this thing we call earth. And he says, just to have the footstool is always the smallest portion of one's furnishing. I can imagine what his feet look like. I know they're polished as brass and beautiful because Yahshua is the exact similitude of Almighty Yah. That's why he made us. It is similitude. It is likeness. He made us that way. He didn't make us in the likeness of the gods. He made us in his likeness. That even the Melechim, they looked and say, what a magnificent thing. What a beauty. He said, the earth is my footstool. He said, Yisrael, my people, where is the house? Where is the bed? Where is the lodging place? Where is the house that you shall erect, you shall build, you will construct for me? If this is mine, you think the house, the bed that Shlomo built, come on, Yisrael, it was a microcosm of the mighty vastness and the riches of Yah. He intended for him to build that house that way. And everything was vital. Those instructions did not come from man. It came out of a mind that was wise, that delighted to know how to present the power of Yah unto Yisrael. That's what we need today. That's what we need today. And because of the sin of the nation of Yisrael, you don't have young men like this that can sit down and labor for hours in Torah, not just sitting around on the internet, but laboring in the Torah, that the preciseness of Yah's order. Yeah. Everybody is great today. Everybody is big. Everybody got a word. Yeah. You understand it? They don't have a damn thing. Nothing. Yah says unto us as a nation, he said, where is the house? Please tell me, what you going to build for me? Will your house even be able to have the breadth, the depth, and the width that I can simply set my throne in it? Where I go, my throne goes. What house? But yet, Yah has erected a house by his hand. It has came. He has sent the power of his knowledge in Yahshua HaMashiach. That he said, if you built me a house that expand the regions of your knowledge, there's only one house that is able to bear me, and that is the house of Yisrael. I will dwell in the bosom. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. He said, I will make my throne in the bosom of Yisrael, in their lab, in their mind, the lab, the heart of Yisrael. We can't build him a house, Yisrael. If we had 100 billion trillion years, we could not build Yah a house. If it took all the resources of what he has made, we could not build him a house. And yet by his own hands, he built a clay house that he is intrigued and honored to dwell in the midst of a house that we cannot even build. So what is the house we're going to build for our Abba, this great one of Yisra'iyah? And he says, and where is the place where I can have a little menucha, a little rest, where I can recline, where I can find me a place to steal away? Where? Where is that? Am I going to find rest in a building? He has caused his truth to rest in the bosom of Yisra'iyah. Only in his people, his elect, will the truth rest, and they will rejoice with great delight because it is precious unto them, Yisra'iyah. Verse 2. Yah says, for all, not some, but kol, all those things have my hand made. I made the heavens. I made the cedar of Lebanon. I made the spruce and the red, giant red spruce that spread throughout the nations where my land comprised of for the heritage of Yisra'iyah. He said, I've made everything with my own hands, my own hand. That's why the hand is important. That's why the mark shall be in the rush, or either the hand. It's more than a number written, Yisra'iyah. It's beyond that. It's beyond that. It will take a messenger the next 100 years preaching and teaching on that. And I could, for this whole, what we call this Gregorian year coming up, I can teach just from the aspect that I began a month ago. I can. He said, I made everything with my hand. And those things have been. Everything you see you're going to utilize, it has been. So what are you going to do? How can you build me a splendid place whereby my splendor can be magnified and the beauty of my essence will be seen by those who, when they look upon that, they should be able to look upon us. Yisra'iyah, great is he. We are the light of the earth. Yisra, a light, as a city that sits upon the hair, the mountain of Yah. Not just any hair, not just any mountain, but the hair, the towering place, the strong place of Almighty Yah. A city that sits upon a hill, not some hills, but a hill, that the light of the aura, the testimony of Yahshua, cannot be hid. There should be a light upon Yisra'iyah. Even when we go places, people marvel. And they will ask us a question. Their minds cannot equate the truth of Yah. It has no power to reason what this I am seeing. And yet they should be able to ask us, do I know you? There's something about you. You look so familiar. What's your name? That should be the incense. The oath, the mark, the distinguished mark of Yisra'iyah. But because we're just like the Gentiles, that's why he had to send Shaul unto the Gentiles, because there was no way that Shaul could identify Yisra'iyah in the midst of a damn corrupt nation scattered abroad other people. You can't even identify the zero of Yisra'iyah today among this heathen nation, not at all. You go to the nations of the earth. If you think you're going to do it by the skin pigmentations, you're a damn fool. If you think you're going to do it by the ability to articulate something out of the Torah, you're even a bigger damn fool. It's going to have to be by a living power of a Torah life that flows from that one. That when they speak it, there is a revolutionary change, even in your conscience, in your mind, when they speak. Every messenger must perform that in the mind of Yisra'iyah. We cannot gather on the Shabbat to give us some kind of an easement that we have done things so precisely according to the commands of Yah and Yahshua, according to the testimony of life in us. We can't gather for that, Yisra'iyah. In everything that the messengers speak, it must begin to make a revolutionary change in our lives.
We began to see the process of Yah invoked in our bosom. We get sister tearing down and then destroying certain elements in our bosom, in our minds. We know this is a damn thing today. Because his judgment, the mishpatim of Yah, his correction, as he has sat before the Melechim, before the courts of adjudication, it doesn't mean a damn thing today, because it doesn't register in the mind of a people that's degenerate, perverse, wicked, and vile. Hell, we get more emotions for Christmas. We have a greater regard for that than we do Yah. And that's the damn truth. You sense when you go out to the stores how that the music make you feel, or just a little different? Even so at this time, because they began months ago. I saw the first trees out in the latter part of August. They began then. They began playing of the songs to train the minds of your children. And hell, we don't read them the story of Pesach to train their minds. What a damnable wicked people. What a damnable wicked people we as Israel are. It's all right them to watch some faggot fishbone, some faggot, what's his name down there in Atlanta? This man that dresses up like this grossly obese fat woman. What's the faggot's name down here? Tyler Perry. It's all right letting them watch Tyler the Fag Perry. What's that character he plays? Mama, hold up. Let me see. I know the character. I'm not that dumb. I'm abreast of things. Mima, what is it? Madea. That's the spirit in that damn faggot. He is a damn Madea. What does even the word mean, Madea? She's the mother of demons, what she is. And they take these men of the diasporas and make them play faggot roles. Talk like women. What's this man on the radio station, the comic, I know his name, Steve Harvey. Talking like women. Will Smith playing the fag role. That is none of you. Then we will let our children laugh and at such things, of such ill repute, vileness. I will come on, man. Yeah, we can't sit down and teach them the beauty of Pesach. The beauty of Torah. We can't teach them the beauty of Sukkoth. We gather in the gathering of God's time. And these dirty damn bastards of hell say that you don't have to keep them all dim. But yet they keep these feast days in their hearts of the world, their holidays, their whore days, their holy days. Because I know what the word holy means. I know its origin. Yah says that my days are kadosh, kadosh, kadosh. They're set apart. Why are they set apart? Because he has sealed them. He has signed the right of that celebration. He created that. This has not come by Kwanzaa and someone creating a time to reflect. Every day of Yah is a day of reflecting for Yisrael, because we meditate day and night in the Torah of Yah. Every day, Yisrael, I won't back down. You will be surprised of the people, Yisrael. I know that there are not many that respond to us. But you will be surprised of those through their subtlety will go and listen to our teachings and the preaching and hear it. Had a man to call me the other day and said, there was an akh that called me and said, listen to this man. Listen to what he says. But the one that told him about me would never contact me. Because they have this air of self-righteousness. And they know that there is someone in the midst of them would dismantle the damn lies, would dismantle them and handle them. They don't want that. That's the strength of a man. He wants to see the beauty of a man. The Torah tells us to mark Do we go and mark a, he says, a tomim, a perfect, an upright man? He said, for the way of that man or the end of that man is shalom. He rests in the Torah of Yah. He rests in the knowledge of the Torah of Yah. That's the end of that man. He says, I want you to to put a distinguished mark upon him, that when you see him, that there's a change in your countenance, that even there's an expression in your brows that you see him. Oh, that man, I liked it. I like to talk to him. Let me go talk to him. Oh, I love talking to him. He tells us to mark that man, doesn't he? Sure, he tells us that. Y'all cannot lie. You mark the perfect man, a man that is tomim, that his mind is ordered by the discipline and the meditation of the Torah of Yah, and the man that walks tzaddik. He walks in the righteousness of the Torah of Yah, because at the end of the day, through all the processes of life, the man still has shalom. He rests in the comfort because he knows that all things that Yah has ordained for his life works for the tav, because he knows he loves Yah. Even his nafal, when his mind has not eclipsed over or overcome the pinnacle or the hurdle in his life, he knows that. You mark a man that is excellent in his desire for Yah. You should mark that man. You follow that man. And this is a generation that doesn't want that. We've been taught by dirty Jezebel, a slut of a whore. She's taught our young men to be weak and effeminate faggots. You're not strong. Better that a young man came up with a daddy, didn't know a damn thing about the Mosai or a damn God. That yet he had a constitution of his discipline. Boy, get out of here. Go do that, boy. Get up from out of here, boy. Laying around here all day. It's better for that than to have a damn cheese puff. They want to grin and stand and play the damn games with him. And that's the truth, man. I don't give a damn if you don't like me. You don't even like you. Because if you like you, you would deal with your sins and your wickedness. Oh, I'm going to teach on the mark today, all right? Don't worry. This is part of the teaching of the mark, okay? It's the conscience that is the prey, totally opposite of the mind of Yahshua HaMashiach. This is what Shaul said, let that's mine, let the mind, not just any mind, the same mind which is the Uth of Yah. It is the mark, it is the distinct mark of Yah, it is the excellence of Yah. That mind, please Yah on all things. And so the mind that is the mark of the beast of a government or an establishment that is diametrically opposed unto Yah, it only has one purpose. That is to dismantle, destroy, to bring down, to eradicate in a knowledge of Almighty Yahweh. And what it does, it began to eradicate Yahshua, the Torah, the disciplines, the writings, the statutes, the things that Yah ordained. He knows what is right for us. And this is a damn corrupt mind. So what it does, this mind, because Yah has given command to that mind, it celebrates a damn Christmas. It ordains a damn Halloween. It ordains every kind of pagan institution of reveling and banqueting against the modem of Yah. That's why Yisrael, as we hasten to the time of Pesach, the Bath of Tizayon, preparing themselves as a wedding, making their garments, making sure they're beautiful, that their isha, that the garments are made, they're beautiful, they're dressed in the aura of their isha, and the ruach of Yahshua HaMashiach resides apart and in the gathering of Yisrael. The only thing you see is damn flesh, the damn corrupt flesh. They gather the women dressing like whores and the men effeminate faggots. You faggot that's there in Kentucky, don't write me. I told you to stop listening to me. Don't listen to me. There's a man that I've sent several offerings here. I wrote him the other day and I said, don't send another dime here. I will not accept it. I will refund his money, and I mean that. You're not going to think that you're going to buy some kind of righteousness with me because you sin offerings, and I know your damn wicked heart is not right. I will not accept it. I will not receive the offering from the man. You understand? And this faggot that says, I love money, you send an offering. Chuck B at 64, child of hell, he'll go and listen. The coward ass, other day he posts another post and I post it. He doesn't realize he's such a stupid mind. The only thing I have to do is delete it. No one would ever see it, but I want the people to see it. I want them to judge me according to his words. Someone replied to him the other day, say, man, you don't know what you're doing. This is a messenger of Yah. I don't know who the person said that. You're going to cause great harm upon you and your family. And the person doesn't even know if the man has a family. Proceeding. Proceeding. Yah says, for all those things have my hand made, and though all those things they have been, says Yah, but to this man, he's talking about a man, he's talking about Jacob, he's talking about Yoshua, he's talking about Yisrael, even to him that is dull, that is poor, he is thin, he says, and that man is of a contrite ruach. He saves such, it is of a contrite ruach. He saves such, and of a broken life. He said, but that man that is of a contrite ruach. And he said, this man must tremble. He must harid. He must be terrified and afraid. He must tremble. He said, at my daba, my promises, my word. We don't even tremble at the word of Yah. We don't even harid. Our minds don't tremble. We don't become dislodged or disjointed from our fleshly nature. We don't. We don't become disenfranchised or disassociate ourselves with things or a nature that is far removed from Yah. This man, we are a man that we must tremble. We must harad. We must tremble at the word of Yah. We must find in that word that he has granted unto us his mercies today. His naham. And yet death is in the same word. And we don't tremble at that. We are damn fools, Yisrael. It is the might of the beast. That's what the wicked said in his heart. I will not fear Yah. And that's what the might of the beast has taught through the generation through this dirty Jezebel whore called Christianity. He doesn't mean he wants us to fear him. He wants us to tremble. It is almost like a child, a young man standing in the presence of his daddy. He knows he is wrong. He knows that he has done wrong. And he knows that his father, his avat's judgment is just. He knows that his avat can see through him. There are boys that have stood in the presence of their daddies and pissed in their clothes. And said, daddy, you remember that when I was 9 and you got me? There are men now and said, daddy, I literally pissed in my clothes. Because they knew that the judgment of that avat, he will not kill them. Even in his correction, they will find mercies. They will find the favor of his daddy. He will not throw that 9-year child out. He will not put them out to the wolves. But he would correct them. He would do it with forthrightness, preciseness. And when the child will lay on the bed and ponder, and the daddy will check on them to consider him. That's what Yah is doing on this Shabbat. He's checking in on us. He's looking in on us. The child will weep. And as he grew old, he began to comprehend the depths of that great kindness of his father. We don't understand the kindness of our Abba. Because we're so innate. We're so ingrained by the processes of this damn wicked Babel system. We don't even know the power of Yah. We frown. And men that stand. And they stand combatantly. They're here to combat the powers of hell. That's why we will never know the true messengers of Yah when they come. We will never understand them because are they going to kill them? Are their bodies going to lie in the streets for 3 days and 3 nights in Yerushalayim? So they will still kill them today, Yisrael. When a man has the nurturing of the Torah of Yah by the Ruach, and the only reason he can get that nurturing is because the testimony of Yahshua speaks with volume. And when the Ruach speaks from his bosom, it speaks not of what that man has read. He speaks of what the voice of Yahshua speaks. You understand? And that's what we're going to need as a nation. You can see the mark of this vile thing, how it is gravitating. It must be getting the forehead. And there's a reason. I can't wait to get to the examples. But there are things that... It's one thing about us, we're a nation of people, a generation of everything instantaneously. We want everything instantaneously. We hear something today, we run with it. We think we have knowledge of the matter, and we only have a surface understanding of it. Is that even surface? Because it doesn't take much to mar that. It doesn't take much to stretch that from one's head. So we hear someone say something according to our limited understanding and our limited prowlness, or the prowlness is the ability to search and to grasp the depths, the breadth, and the width of things. It's a process where one's minds search it out. It search out every little hidden nuances of the matter. So when one speaks, he speaks with somewhat of a knowledge of the matter. We are a nation, we want things that are instant. We like instant grits. We don't like the old-time grits that were coarse grind. Better for us because it has the fiber there and cleans out our colon and cleans the mess out of us. We don't want that today. We don't want the old-fashioned oatmeal. We want the instant, which tastes like dung. 2 minutes. And the day would take a while, the old-fashioned, the boiled oatmeal, but yet the fiber and all of the essence and all of the essential was there to keep the dung and the waste of our colon, that we don't get huge as damn monsters, Yisrael. We have the grits and the harmony and things like that that were very vital to our natural and physical growth. And it kept the men strong in the cotton fields, kept them strong doing the damn pulpwood. They didn't have these machines to go out there and snip down a tree. They had axes until saws came along. They didn't have nothing to hoist that up. They had backs that were strong. Strong backs. They had a quota for a day. They had to go cut. And they could go out there on these watery thin grits and eggs that mama would get up in the morning and go find them in the hen houses where they had protein and they had what they needed. Their strength. Mama bring them a bag lunch at noon time and they would eat. You see, y'all's not even on our minds in the course of the day. That's why we have no strength. We're weak. We look weak. We're sickly and we're dead. Yeah. Nobody's going to stop me. And I know Yah's not going to stop me. You ignorant man, I know I'm ignorant. He knows that. That's why he's polishing me even now. And if you have the iron of his truth, then iron sharpens iron, doesn't it? All right. So you'll make me sharp. You will make me sharp. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He says in verse 3, he said, I want to show you the example of your attitude toward me. You think you're doing right and you're doing wrong. He said, he that kills an ox is as he slew a man. He can kill a man or an ox. It makes no difference at all. Are we in that kind of generation? He that slew an ox, it is though that like he killed a man. He said, he that offered or he brought the oblation of a lamb as he has cut off a dog's neck. A dog is unclean. It's an unclean offering. He said, the one that has killed the lamb, the presentation unto me, like Cain and Abel, or Hebel, he had respect unto Hebel's offering, but Cain, he had no respect for his offering. Because it was an offering of a dog, of an unclean thing. That's what this damn pagan season is about, Yisrael. That's what the tables are filled with dog meats and swine meat and unclean things. They will have ham today. Starting this evening, they will have the pork chop and the hams and the neck bones and their collard greens. And you sit down in the damn house and say, this is my mama. I don't give a damn who she is. This is my grandmother. I don't give a damn if it's your grandmother. The young man from Mississippi last night, Achken, did you hear his question? My father says the fifth commandment. And I began to quote from the fourth to the first. I said, and your father disregard all of them. He doesn't keep the Shabbat. He doesn't give a honor to his name. He got a damn God in his house, a damn tree. He has built an image. He has placed a damn fat, dirty demon of a dog, his satanic before Almighty. Yah, damn what your father says. Your father has taught you lies. That's why we are dysfunctional. Our mothers taught us lies. Christmas and all the damn pagan lies. You bring your children up in the functionality of Torah. You teach them. You read the stories. Even that babe in your arm, you read the story of Pesach. You remind them and let it become innate in their mind. Their actions will show you. And as you watch her grow, you will see your attitude toward that.
We don't do that. We're wicked. It's the shu'ur of the beast system of the peace mind. It's a lively mind. Do you understand that the word beast or beasts, there are different ways you can enunciate it. Behometh or behumeth, something that is huge, high, life, with life, have substance of life. And when Yah talks in many cases about the beast spirit, he's talking about chai, life, that which brings forth life, a breathing entity, substance of life. That's what he's talking about. And you will never know that unless you will dig beyond your peripheral. You may see something on the peripheral, but if you don't pay attention to it, you miss it. You ever seen something on the side and all of a sudden it was just gone? And there were those that were looking at that. They can tell you the whole sequence of things that went through on that certain situation. Sure they can. Bohemoth. Ha. Hallelujah. Those that bring the offering of the lamb is like they cut a dog's neck off. And he that offer an oblation, as if he offer swine blood, he says, so sacrilege and so wicked. He said, the offering is though they brought something so vile and so unclean to me that it stinks in my nostrils. It's vile, it's repugnant. He said, even the oblation of Toda unto Yah, that's what an oblation is, that we should lift our hands and greet him and say, Toda Yah. He said, even the praise of offering of singing unto me is like it's like swine blood pouring out of them. Because it's not done with a sincere motive, it's not done with an enthusiasm, it's not done with the motivation of the testimony of Yahshua HaMashiach. We just react because of the circumstances. That should not be Yisrael. We shall act according to the instructions of Almighty Yah. That's what we should do. What does the Ima tell the Isha, the Ima tell the child? Well, what about that? What is that, Mama? Who is Santa Claus? Well, it's a damn lie, baby. Child, it is one of the most hideous lies, a concept that is so evil. And as you get older, I'll teach you that you can't comprehend, but don't touch that. Don't let that man touch you. Don't ever, if you see someone dressed like that, don't ever let them touch you. And baby, they teach them, if a stranger come near you, don't receive no candy, anything, don't they? But they send their babies out the houses of damn pedophiles and strangers begging for candy. This is the damn duplicity of this generation. And we are as nutty as they are. They set their babies on some pedophile laps that don't even know the mind of a beast and say, smile and take a picture. And the baby got enough sense. The baby began to cry once down and they compelled them, they coerced them, they forced them to sit on some big fat demon's lap. He's getting off his sensual pleasures on your babies. Don't think that there are a lot of men that have gone into that just to get their sensual pleasures off on your baby. They're known as pedophile. They're pedophilia. And they want to do that. You put your babies on the lap. And they come to your baby and say, ho, ho, ho. And you smile like a damn fool, like an ignoramus out of hell. Give him a kiss, a damn stranger you don't even know. And you don't even kiss your damn baby. And you tell your child to get some kind of beast, a stranger. Come on, Yisrael. That is not God. That's the spirit of a beast. It is a mind that is totally parallel, opposite to the mind of Yah. It is not parallel to the mind of Yah. It's diametric. It opposes. It assaults the mind of Yah. And we give strength and credence to these damn lies. It's wrong. It is a wrong thing, Yisrael. We shall damn it with every fiber that's in us. We shall curse it. When we hear the damn songs, jingle bell, we should curse it. We should curse it in our ears, Yisrael. Let it be a color unto my hearing. And began to sing, I can do all things through the power of Yahshua, the power of the testimony of HaMashiach that give me strength. You don't participate in it. You don't go among them. I don't like going out. Well, my first time out was just 2 weeks ago, Thursday. I went out. This Thursday when you all went out to pick up a few things. I don't like going out.
We went out, asked Jimmer and I to get the bread, and that was it. I don't like going out. We should even put our children under that pressure. We should not. You think that it doesn't have significant power. The power of the subliminal is great. I remember as a young individual learning how that the subliminal, how that they would insert just a billion of a second of a clip of popcorn in the movie theaters, and everybody's running for popcorn. Then they will produce Milk Duds. That's all they sold in the theaters. Popcorn, Milk Duds, Almond Joy, a Patty or something like in the day. That's all they sold. And everybody, as soon as they went and the movie began, it wasn't 20 minutes, everybody wanted popcorn. Everybody. Because they had the power to inject in the mind. And if you think as little babies, as you read to them when they were in your belly, in your Bethlehem, then you know that if a child's little mind is developing, you think that the powers that be in the spirit of this beast Mark, how was the babies that Herod began to kill? Were they two and older or two and younger? Were they two and older, two and younger? Two and younger, were they not? When they wanted to eradicate the one of the marsh Moshe, were they two and to 50 or were they younger than that? They were younger, Yisrael. He went out and tried to destroy everyone that came out of the womb, you kill. Every Hebrew that came out of the womb, you butcher them like a beast. Everyone you kill. Because they're going to grow up to be like these other Hebrews, and we want to eradicate them. And so the enemy has become slick, but Yah has it all in control. He just wants his servants to be wise that we can teach Yisrael. I don't give a damn how illiterate, how ignorant we are to things. We can prepare ourselves in a way. I don't give a damn who you are, man. I don't care your limited ability to teach, to instruct. You can search the Torah and take time to be deliberate and study out things that every time you stand before the people of Yah, you will have a message that is pulsating. It is of substance. It is of strength. It is of the essence of the power of Yah. It promotes the very character and the strength of Almighty Yah. And then those that look at you will see you in a different light, will see a strength and a beauty about you that you don't even know you have. But it takes a deliberate effort to study and to dig down into the simplicity of that. Not just a plethora of reading, my friends. No. You must explain things to its depth. You get instructions to do something, does it not tell you? First of all, it tells you the first thing it tells you to do, what it tells you. Can I tell you? I'll tell you the first thing it tells you. Can I tell you? I'll tell you the very first thing it tells you. It is not complex to put together anything. The first thing it tells you. The first thing. The first thing it tells you. First thing it shows you. It shows you all the parts. The first thing it tells you to lay out everything in order. The screws here. A screw, you got 10 of those. B screws, you got 18. C nuts, you got 30. And if you lay everything out, like it says, then you pick up part A. You pick up part A and want to put Z to that together, but no, that's in the process. You pick up A, and then it tells you when you pick up A, you take part H. You think B should go there. That's the way we are. I am notorious for that. Because I look on the box and see how it looked, and figure it out from there. And then I have a part missing. And extra screws and extra things. And that's what we must do, Yisrael. We're not a people that labor in the Torah of Yah. We're not a people that labor in the Torah of Yah. Hallelujah. Proceeding in this process, I'll get to what I'm going to teach. I will bring some things that are very vital to us today, all right? Although this is vital, I must touch on this. It is all part of the system. He says, and continue in verse 3, he that burn incense is as he blessed an idol. The offerings, the incense, the sweet smell of this aroma that flows from them. Is not Yahshua the sweet smell of the fragrance of Yah? And yet from us flow this fragrance of idol pagan worship and pagan desire and pagan delight. He said, yes. This is what he says. Emphatically, does he use the word kin? He says yes, doesn't he? It is affirmed. There is no alternative. He says yes. He signifies with that word. He says yes, they have chosen their own ways, not way. We have elected and chosen our own ways. And our ways are important unto us. Yah said, you as a nation, you have elected and chosen your own ways. We have chosen our own ways. We have chosen our own correct things. We have chosen that which is wrong. We say this is right and that is wrong. Although that is right, which you call wrong, and your way is wrong. That's what we have done. And that's the mind of the beast. That's his intent, to try to misplace the very order of the judicial process of Yah with his all damnable corrupt matter, his ways. And so Yah says to us, yes, it is emphatic. I give you examples as to how they bring me offerings and their heart bring an offering, but their heart is not in it. They sing, but it doesn't mean a damn thing. We're getting older, and yet we don't realize the joy of Yah is our strength. And we don't even personify that, Yisrael. Something is twisted in our damn twisted minds. You get excited over damn pair of shoes. I will mourn. But you don't get excited over, man, I found me some shoes. Damn the shoes. He found me. He had to dig through a pile of not even dog's dung. I'd rather go out there. I can pick up raw cow's dung any day. I'd rather pick that up any day than pick up dog swine, dog dung. I'll pick it up with my hand. It doesn't take much to wash that off. But the smell of a dog... The true proverb, the dog has returned back to what? His own vomit. We have elected our own ways. That is the true proverb. The dog has returned back to his own. Same word, O-W-N. His own vomit. A dog puke, and he goes back to his own puke. And those things that have been regurgitated to our forefathers through the generation, we're returning back to that. They leave Yah and they go back to that. They leave a place of discipline, even like this place, and they go back to their own dirty, filthy ways. Their sons and daughters are more evil than them. They're doing things that even their daughters are given into lust for even other women and their sons, even into a spirit of such vile nature. I was talking, I think, to Ach Shimeon, one of the Ach Shimri, one of them, I don't recall. And I said to them, I had a call for my natural brother. And he was telling me that even his natural son is a blatant, flagrant faggot dog out of hell. What daddy is going to rejoice if his sons come to him and say, I'm a faggot? And he said, my daughter's worse than that. Afra's nothing but a low-down butch bull dagger. A dirty slut. I wouldn't even make mention of the damn beast. That's right. What man would have a sense of his beauty? A damn faggot for a son and a butch bull dagger. Oh, they're not the only one. You got those that are left from here that the girls are sleeping with other girls. And the little young ones that I would hold in my arms and play jump rope with. Nothing but hoes. That's what they are. Just flat out hoes and dogs. I saw one day that as a baby, I would hold her, kiss her, keep her, put on my chest, and she would go to sleep. And I saw one day, I saw her. I walked in the store, and there she was. And she wasn't even dressed like a bitch. You think that that doesn't smite my heart. You all may think that I'm a careless man and I don't care because you're foolish. And my heart was so smitten that the tears, I didn't even look at them again. I walked to take care of what I was taking care of. And when they saw me, they were afraid. They stood back just like this. I wasn't going to say anything to them. You don't have to worry about me saying anything to you. In my heart, I say, Maya, this child I have, and I will lay the child on my chest. And when she was crying, I've always been able to take a baby, put them here on my chest, and they would fall asleep, always. And I would take that little baby that was so precious to my Ishua, and I would put that child here and lay down. And it wasn't long the little child would go to sleep. And I saw this thing and I said, oh yeah. I didn't even look back at them. And they watched me the whole time. They stayed away and they looked like this. Instead of turning this way to confront them, I turned this way and walked this way. I don't want to see them. I don't rejoice in that. Or they may try to rejoice in what they perceive as my destruction. I'm not going down. Because I know I can't go around the Torah of you. I can't go over it. Yahshua is the door. We must come in at the door. We must come to Yah through the heart of Yahshua. We cannot get to him any other way. The heart of man is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. I can't get to him through my heart. It must be through the mind of Yahshua HaMashiach. Must be. Because my mind will choose my own ways. And your mind will too. Yah says, they have chosen their own ways. And he says that their nefesh, not just the hidden matter of man, but the nefesh, it gives us a greater connotation than what we say soul. It is the wholeness of man. It is the breath in him. It is the invisible thing. And it is this being. He said, and the nefesh and their nefesh, he says, delights or chafetz. They enjoy it. It is the excitement. The nefesh delight. He said that we delight in our own to'eba, our filth, our abomination, our uncleanliness. Is not this one, this mother of harlotry, written upon her forehead? Is she not the harlot? Is she not the mother of all abominations to Eba? And we rejoice in our own abominations, our filth. He said, that's what my people are doing. They're rejoicing in their own filth. There's nothing more abominable than this damn dog mass, what they're celebrating tomorrow. It is a dog mass. It is a swine mass. It is the swine. It is the reverence unto the pig meat. The tables are unclean. Clam chowder. Oysters. That's how these damn pigs eat. Well, I don't eat swine. Well, they got every damn thing that's offered on their table. Do not they decorate their table? In some of the most run down and some of the most blighted communities, they will go beg to have enough bread or a meal for that season to offer it unto the dogs of hell. It's wicked, Yisrael. I don't give a damn, mother, what your educational experience is. You can get books. Your babies can read better than you. You can find the things in the Torah. Read that, baby. You read that. You read this. To understand the beauty of the Mo'adim of Yah and the time of his season. That it become impregnated in their minds, and as they grow, they develop, it becomes a part of them. That's why the enemy is taking your babies at that age. He's taking your babies in the womb. He's taking your child before they're born. And the first thing you do, you put them on some damn Similac milk, not even a mother's care, mother's kindness, a mother's tenderness, and you feed that child some of the most damnable, some of the most polluted type of ingredients in their minds to destroy them. You damn Jezebel, and you fag of a man. There's one time y'all winked at our ignorance, but he's not winking anymore. He says he's going to destroy them that destroy the earth. I was reading this morning in the Observer. You all just forgive me today. Whichever way I go, all right? I was reading this morning. And my friend, Lindsay, we would go to Lake Norman. And Big Daddy Lindsay, we would go there in the schools of bass, largemouth, white. We would go there and have a field day, the white bass. Big Daddy Lindsay, let's go fishing. I'm coming. I'll give you some gas money, you and me, just he and I. And you could catch fish, and when you would cook them, they were so pristine, the taste, so beautiful. You could go right home. I said, Big Daddy, I'm going to clean me some now. He said, I am too. I said, you got 30 miles to go by the time you get home. Mommy's already fried mine. And I was reading this morning, warning the people that the bass and the fish in Lake Norman, warning us about eating it. For the mercury content, they cause the minds of your children to become lunaticish. Destroy the brain cells. Because of the damn greed and the wickedness of those. And they get on the waters and their folly and their frivolity, their mercury outboard motors, and they're wasting the fuel and just their drunkenness and polluting the water. He's going to kill them. He's going to destroy them. That destroy the earth. That's Yah's mandate. This damn wicked nation alone has spent, since the beginning of this festivity, $469 billion. And that's the economy of 100 nations in the earth today. They have spent that on folly. Yet they will cause the little young children on the continent of Africa at 4, 5, 6 to work in the mines all day for some slut, some whore, to get what she called a gold or diamond ring, to get a new iPhone. They will cause the backs of those in Indonesia, in China, and India to work on our damn factory line. That these damn heathens in this damn wicked nation will kick each other in the damn head to get a pair of the Air Jordan sneakers. And the damn fool of a mammy will drop $180 a pop for a damn $10 pair of sneakers because it has an image of one dunking a ball. This the stupidity of this damn generation, and you will buy that. And yet you stand before Yah's messenger and will not send a damn dime to strengthen the labor of Almighty Yah. My friend Achmikaya sent me a clip. I saw it in the Observer this morning, how they were lined up for hours, for days, to be the first one to buy a pair of damn sneakers. And hell, you can't even get them to come into Yah's house and all. So he sent me this clip in Indiana. Gary, Indiana is one of the most blighted places upon the face of the earth. Just like Detroit. It was a place at one time where the people of the diaspora had a blooming industry and business. Because 80% of the people of that area were people of the dark-hued skin color. And now the monies have been taken out. They don't have a damn thing. And you have nearly 60% unemployment. But yet on the outskirts, they put the tennis shoes on sale. Because this individual they call Michael Jordan is a damn god. Damn Michael Jordan. He's a rowdy womanizer. He's an adulterous beast of a dog. That's what he's a damn womanizer. He's a gambler. He's a drunkard. And yet they gloat and they marvel at a man like that. They're all because they touch his hand. He's no different than any other man because he can dunk a damn ball. What does that mean? You get one that possesses some kind of problemness of intellectual, there's a disdain for him, for her. Because Rihanna can shake her ass. There was a magazine in France that they said about her the other day. It's a big article. That they said that, now if I use the word, we get offended. They asked the editor to retract it, but the editor said no. See, everybody knows that Rihanna, she got that ghetto ass. It says she has a ghetto ass. And she's nothing but a nigga bitch. That's what the paper said. That's what it said in France. That's what their paper said. And so we had this uproar with some of the most liberal newspapers said, you can't say that about her. You ought to apologize. Well, the woman who wrote the article said, well, look at her ass there. Look at her. That's what she acts like. She acts like one of those ghetto whores. And this is the image of the bath of Tizayon. And it ought not to be. You straighten your damn hair to look like these crazy people. Blondes have more fun. All the blondes I see are dirty whores. All the blondes I see, and look at Paris Hilton. Look at this dirty whore, Lindsay Lohan. Look at Marilyn Monroe. She slept with more men than she can count the number. And nothing but whores on poles, pole dancing. And yet the beauty and the exquisiteness and the essence and the ebony of a bath of Tizayon and your beauty, yet you're ashamed of that. You're a damn fool. You're a stupid woman. That's what Babel had done to the mind. I don't care if you get mad. I don't care. I don't care about offending. I don't give a damn about offending you. You offend y'all. They're burning their baby's head out with this fire. Hell, even those that call themselves cosmetologists, you know, they deal in the cosmos. That's why they have these crazy hairstyles. Is that the cosmos out there? It's the cosmos. And they dig it in your baby's hair and putting them damn chemicals. They got enough sense to put gloves on and put a mask on their face. You're getting your toenails painted. They got enough sense to do that. They ain't that stupid. Even they got enough sense. And you know, notice most of those Koreans or Chinese, you don't notice them have it. Do they have that? No. You don't see the women dressed like that. I'm an astute student. I observe everything. I say, is that amazing? Here, this woman looks like she's 60 years old. She's bigger than me. Now she's looking at me because she thinks that there's some charm about her, that I'm looking at her, that I admire. I'm looking at you. You're a damn fool, woman. You're a big buffalo of a fool. You're stupid. Here you're getting your toes painted up like that. And they sit there looking. Oh, I go by that when the place was enlarged at Walmart. I will look and just look at them like. And so when they see a man that they perceive he has some charm and some beauty to him, sure they do. They say, oh, he's looking at me. Yeah, I am, woman. But you don't know why. And I just look. You're stupid. You are a bimbo of a fruitcake. You are as nutty as they come, woman. And I just look. And they're smiling. Hi. I don't respond. You're a stupid, woman. And even the Koreans don't even wear it. They plait that damn mess in the women's hair, the dog hair from poor women across the world. The little women in India must cut their hair to sell it. And these Jezebels in this nation add all this damn false hair for damn night to be a hoe. I don't know why I'm going that way, but that's all right. They're going to hoe it up here starting tonight. Funky drunk. And I believe Jesus is the reason for the season. He's a damn freak, he is. He's a damn freak. Their Jesus is a damn freak. I know their Jesus because I've seen his picture, and that's him. That's his image. We are the image of Yeshua HaMashiach. He's a damn freak, man. He's a damn freak. He's a damn freak. And they're going to do the freaky funky chicken tonight. They're going to do the damn freak stuff tonight. Cousins touching cousins, kin folks. They coming from New York. They coming from Georgia. They coming from Mississippi. And they're gathering in the swine den. They're going to eat. They're going to go out. They're going to get drunk. And they're going to lay one with the other. Yah said, I fed you, Yisrael. Yah gave you bread. I gave you matcha. He said, you got drunk. You ate. Your bellies were full. And then you rose up and played. You played like harlots. Another touching another man's wife, his daughter. Come on, Yisrael. Yah. Jirach says, when we see a shapely woman, we should even turn our eyes and run from that. We should be careful how we interact with another ox. Ishaw, with another man's wife, with a singular daughter of Tizayon. I've never been one to chit-chat with women. I don't play that. The only women that I will have any kind of conversation with that are mature elderly women. I don't like the simple, even older women. I don't like messing with them. When I find daughters that are mature, I will speak to them. When I find them that are silly as hell, I don't mess with them. I don't mess with immature women. I don't like talking to them. I don't like dealing with them. And I don't at all deal with the young Baptist Zion. They need to be taught. They need to be taught how to love their husbands and to honor them and to show love. They don't know a damn thing. So what is it that I'm going to talk to them about? What they need to do is listen to me. You understand? Can I proceed a little farther? I've just messed this Shabbat up. But that's all right. This will be a collage, but I'm not going to stop my teaching, believe me. This is the beast's power that it allows. Yah, he is allowing this. Let me proceed, all right. He said, they have chosen in Yeshaya, Isaiah 66:3. Yes, they have chosen their own way, and their nephesh delight in their abomination. Yah says this in verse 4. Does it say, I will also... Does Yah say, I also will choose? Did he say, I also will choose? Did he say, I also will choose their delusion? He said, I will choose their ta'ula. Does he say that? He said, I will choose their ta'ula. Is Christmas a delusion? Sure it is. Yah has chosen this day to delude the people. He has chosen this day. That's what we must understand. He's in control. Don't let it frustrate you whereby you get vexed. Well, damn Christmas. These fools out here. Damn their foolish ways, Yisraya. Yah has chosen the delusion. We must understand that. He said, hey, I want Christmas. I want a big fat devil. Paint him up. Put him in a red and white suit. Give him a grotesque belly. Let him know he is a beast. That's how cows look, don't they? Come out there in the field, that's how cows look. Let everyone know that he is a beast like a pig. And he's a greedy damn dog too. He comes to your house, he slides down this big fat bastard. He's on the bastard slip. He has no identity with the Abaddon. Anyone that has no power of the birth of Yeshua, that's a bastard. I don't give a damn if a child is born out of wedlock. That means nothing. That has no identity at all. Nothing at all. That means nothing. He's a bastard. They are bastards. He's able to send that fat bastard. I want to send that dirty bastard. He's a bastard. I want that bastard to slide down the chimneys. 71% of the Americans? Believe that without Saint Nick, you have nothing at all. Up 24% 5 years ago. These are the younger generations that are establishing the creeds of this. He's going to damn them all. He's going to kill them. He's going to destroy them. He's going to break them down to the gates of hell. And that's the truth, Yisrael. That's why we are the pattern or the tasneith of Yah. We are the pattern of the beauty of his Mo'adim. We should celebrate the Mo'adim with Yah with great pleasure, with excitement, with a great fervor, Yisrael. You about to begin to prepare for Pesach now. What I'm going to, how we're going to, what a beautiful time. Yes. Only thing we prepare for is Walmart and Hell Kmart. Dollamart, Aldi's, and all that damn mess. We're feeding the God of our damn bellies. We don't give a damn about the Most High. Y'all said I would choose their delusion. So is he sitting the one who's coming after the working of our short tongue? Is he coming with deceit? Is Christmas based upon deceit? Is it based upon a shekha, a lie of deception? Yah said, I will choose the delusion. He who coming after the working of Hashatan, he's coming with lying wonders, miracles, and all kinds of deceivable, wicked signs. Yah said, I have chosen the delusion. Is that what he says? I also will choose their delusion, and I will bring their fear upon them. He said, I'm going to bring the fear. I'm going to choose the delusion, and I'm going to bring fear upon them. Because when I called, is he calling us today? Sure he is, Yisra'iyah. He said, when I call some, a few, just a little, he said, lo, no one, none, not one. When I call, when I chara, when my voice was made loud, when I caused my voice to thunder out of Hashemayim like the thunders, and even those among Yisra'iyah knew that it was me. When I caused the voice of Yahshua to speak as no other man has heard. He said, when I call, none. When I call, none. It would have been nice if he said, I call. There were some mighty men there, or there were a few men there. He said, when I call, when I kara, when I made my voice to be known, he said, none did answer. Not one answer. We sing the song, he called, I will answer. We don't have the ruach of Shemuel. We don't have that ruach. We don't even have the insight, even though Eli was a wicked man. He said, when he called a God and say, here I am, Yah. We don't say, here I am, Yah. Yah's calling us today, he's speaking. He said, this is my delusion. I am the one that orchestrate this damn lie. It's a lie. Because they receive not the love of the Torah, Yahweh shall send them strong delusion. For what reason? That they may believe what? A lie. Do they believe the lie of Christmas? Yes. They believe the lie of Xmas. Yah has sent this strong delusion. That they may believe that damn lie. He wants them to believe the damn lie. He wants them to believe the damn lie. Why? That they all might be damned. He's going to damn them. He's going to damn them. That's my mama. He's going to damn your mama. That's my son. He's going to damn them. That's my precious daughter. She's not precious. She's not precious. She believe a lie. She substantiate a lie. She embolden a lie. She strengthens a lie. She promotes a lie. That's not a daughter. That's a Jezebel. That's a dirty beast. That's a slut. That's not even a slut. That's a dirty dog. You've been emboldened by a damn lie? You substantiate a lie? Y'all said, I will send the delusion. He will send a strong delusion. I'll read that quickly. Y'all help me to get to what I need to today. But I will get to what I need to today, all right. I will get to truth. I will get to the mark that marks our mind. And it is the same mark of the beast, all right. I will get to truth. That's all that matters. Truth. Well, Dave Roberts, I won't even call you David Yisra'iyah, Dave Roberts. Your words are not very choice. I know. I don't intend for them to be choice words lined with silver. I intend for them to be crude and rude because you're rude. You are crude against Yah and you're rude to him. You won't even answer him. It's almost like one calling someone and they know it's you and they see the number, they won't even answer. They won't even pick the telephone up. Is not that a weak man or woman? Is that the nature of one that loves someone that's a coward? Well, you won't answer me. I've told you, man, don't call me. I don't want to be bothered with you. That is settled. I don't want your fellowship. I don't want to break bread with you. I know that you are of Yehuda spirit. You will betray. You're proven you will betray. Why in hell do I want to break bread with you? I know you have a mind of the perdition. You're a child of hell. You have the mark of the beast. In the world, I didn't betray my boys. In the world, I didn't betray my boys. In the world, I didn't betray my boys. I can tell, I can interact with people and tell how they were in the world. If you have no camaraderie with me or with the Akh, you don't want to socialize. You were like that in the world. See, I was like that. And when I was in the world, my boys, they were my boys. We were straight. We did everything together. We went places. We wanted everybody to see us. Sure, we did. No lie about it. They were my boys, man. Come on, I was the little nub. I was the short one. These cats were all taller than me, like him. TK 6'8", Don Juan 6'5", 6'6". And I'm the little nub between them. But they were my boys. My boy Will from Tuskegee, Alabama, he was smooth and he was a nice looking fella. Boy, he was handsome. He was handsome. Sure he was. My boy Cole Bev from New Orleans, Louisiana, about 6'3". Come on, I was a nub, Yisrael. Sure, but they were my boys. Ziggy out there, Reedsville, North Carolina. We call him Trash Can, and that's the way he walked to. So if I had $100, Ziggy needed that. But Rob, my mother, man, she needed a little money. You know, all right, Zig, come on, boy, here it is. Bam. I pay you back. Come on, Zig, don't go that way with me now. Don't do me like that. Because I know if Zig had 50, I could get 50. That's the way we were. We didn't betray each other. We didn't betray each other. We were tight. We were straight. We were right. We had a camaraderie. And if I didn't see my boy today, something was trouble about me. Come on, man. That's my boy. What's up? I go find him. Come on, TK. What's up? That's the way it was with me. We sought each other out. I didn't go anywhere without them. We enjoyed the fellowship. Come on. Even though we were wicked, we had a sense of a greater connection than I found among Israel. We somewhere out. Come on, TK, you like them, man. Bro, Rob, I ain't got enough cash, man. Come on, here. How much? $100? Come on, I'll buy you a pair. That's the way we did things. That's the way I did it. I've always been like that. Can I tell you this event? I'm going to finish. I remember this what broke me from most young men that at my age at that time. I'm not going to lie to you all. I've been as wicked as any man, and I have. I remember back in the early 70s, they had the bell bottoms, and at that time, they had some plaid ones. They were real expensive. They were nice plaid bell bottom slacks. There was a store out at South Park that they sold nice fashionable slacks. I mean, when you wore a pair of those to school, everybody knew that you had spent a little change. They were probably $25, $30 in those days. That was a lot of jack. People were not even making that much a week, many places, you understand. So that was a week's salary for people. My mother wasn't making money, $60 a week, even at that time, that's all. It wasn't a lot of money. And I'll never forget the individuals. We called one, his name was Ronald. And the other one, his name was Melvin. We called him Tonk. And I wanted them to be my friend, you understand. And even though their girlfriends like me, I would not even touch them. I could have had their girls, but I didn't want them, you understand? And I recall going out to South Park that day. We went out there, Ronald had his parents' car, he had driver's license. We went out there, and I use the word boost. We old time hustlers, that were hustlers. You know what the word boost mean, all right? Don't worry about it. And of course, back then, what we would call stealing, we would call it boosting. There were slick ways you could go in the stores, and they had these little young kids, students. They didn't understand the slick mannerism that we in the hood operated in. So I had one of their shopping bags. I went in that store. I feel it. Ronald picked out everything he wanted. Tonk picked out everything he wanted. I picked out all my clothing. You had to do it in a methodical, slick way. And so when I left the store, I was dressed real nice and neat. When I left the store, they didn't know what was what. And I walked out of that store, a shopping bag full of the things that they wanted and I wanted. And it wasn't a week later that those individuals, they came against me so wickedly. Even though I was wicked, I was more wicked than them. And that taught me something. I was, what, 16, 17 years. That taught me a valuable lesson right then. And from that moment, I've never liked being around cats my age, because I thought they were young, they were immature, they had no sense of direction, no focus. They didn't have the mature state of older men. And from that point, I began to gravitate to the older men, the older cats. And those were the men that I hung around, because I saw a sense of loyalty. Even though they were thugs and hustlers, there was a loyalty there. There was a reverence, and they honored each other, and they would take care of you. They did not, there were times that they would try to rip you off. But in most cases, if you were part of the hustle, you got your fair share, regardless. And that's the way they operated. And that cats today, even today, all the cats, that those men that they hung around with, they still hang around with them. They still know them, because there was a form of integrity there. It was honesty there. It was. How much we make, man? We made $300. All right, everybody get a bill apiece. And that's the way they did it. They didn't lie and cheat like they do today. And so from that point, young cats, I didn't even like them. And so my mannerism came from men that were older, from men that were more mature, from men that had a sense, although they were wicked, and they taught me wicked things, but they were always trying to direct the young ones on the path what was right. Don't do what I do, man. I know what I'm doing. I'm just an old-time hustler, man, but you don't go that way. You go to school, get an education. That's what you do. They will always do that. You understand? So that's what Yah is telling us. Don't go your way. You go his way. Don't go your own ways, but you go the way of Yah. Hallelujah. Even there are us that are even defensive of that, of this damn thing. There are many of those that are defensive of this pagan celebration, what they call celebration. Hallelujah. 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 Quickly to Thessalonica, 2 Thessalonica, chapter 2. You know, I'm doing this for the reason of those that need this. That young man, I told him to tell his father, his Isha, all them, Akin there in Mississippi, to call. You understand, to listen today. They may not listen, but maybe he may go on later today and pull this message up. I know what path we need to take just for this occasion. All right, Yisrael. So you just trust me on that. You trust me on that, okay? It says here in the book of Thessalonica, 2 Thessalonica. I want to read that a little bit. 2 Thessalonica, chapter 2. 2 Thessalonica. Chapter 2. Let me find that quickly. Where is that? 2 Thessalonica chapter 2. Let me move that quickly. All right. 2 Thessalonica, Thessalonians chapter 2. Hallelujah. Is not one, Yah, the one that will choose the delusions, Yisrael? Hallelujah. I want to read this quickly here. Hallelujah. 2 Thessalonica chapter 2. But I'm going to close from this book, all right? All right. Hallelujah. When I finish this, and I will get back, I'm going to teach. This is, you got to understand, even though I'm not teaching the mark in the hand or the head, I am teaching that Yisrael. But I will get to the Pacific, because it is a mind that is totally delusional. It is a mind that opposes Yah in every aspect. It is a mind that fight valiantly against Yah. I don't see why. We don't have to do that. You don't. The boss man said, I want you here at 6:30. Do you get up at 6 to get there at 6:30? No. Everybody is right except Yah. By his immutability, he cannot lie, but yet they call him liar. And they say that he is a liar. He said there should be an ordinance, Ulam Viat, forever, for your sons. He told you to teach your sons and your sons' sons. Does he not tell the commands us to do that? So you, Ima, you began to teach in your home. Instead of laying around sleeping, get up and teach. Instead of laying around in your house is dirty, get up, clean your house, woman. I'm telling you, all you, Ima, you, all you precious Isha, you about to design. Keep your house clean. Get up. Get off your lazy backside. I don't give a damn if you have nothing but Clorox, and go from one room to the other and clean. My grandmother washed with a washing board, and she would go and wash our clothes, and she would teach the other ones how to do it. Don't tell me you can't do that. Keep your house clean. Clean your damn house. Clean your damn house. Clean up around your house. Even though we were children, we were, if nothing else, we would get the broom straw. We didn't have no grass. Do what? Sweep the yard. We did that. Grant and go out and gather the broom straw. We didn't have no fancy broom like we have today. That's what we swept the house with. Little old broom bar like that. She cut that broom straw and you go out there and you swept the house with that. House had an odor in there, it would be cold. Yowza, let them windows up in there. Yowza. Didn't have no window screens. Let them up. Disman this house. You're not going to let bed, Granny, come in there. Let everyone up in the house. That cold autumn breeze start flowing in there. You have to get up. Mama, you're the only one knows what I'm talking about. Okay, then. You're the only one know. You had to get up. I know you know. You had to get up. You got up because it was getting cold, baby. And there was no fire to keep you warm. You got up. You understand? We didn't have this fancy polluted ingredients and things that are killing our immune system. Hell, she will boil some pine needles or something like that. Pine cone. Green pine cones. Come on, talk to me. I want to read this quickly here, Yisrael. We greet you all that have joined us. And even you that have fallen off, that's all right. I know sometimes it's tough to bear someone like me. Listen a little bit, put me down, and then go back a little bit, and you'll find yourself listening. Like my precious Ahotsa, Diana, and her Ish Frank there in Nebo, West Virginia. As I read you her testimony, she didn't like listen to this man, but she found herself one day just listening. And as our precious Beth Tizayon found herself listening, she began, as Yah began to open up her heart and her mind, saying, this is right. This is true. Then the power of that testimony, the light of his truth, Yahshua became real. His power became real. He began to manifest himself in her. And the first thing after that, my sister Diana, come on, Ach Frank, she began to have the great trials and the enemy began to war against her. But you're all right, my hope. Be encouraged. Don't worry about a thing. Hallelujah. Quickly here out of 1 Thessalonians chapter 2. Shaul says, for you yourself, my brothers, the elect of Yisrael, he says, you Yara, you know what entrance or the way that I came unto you. That it was not shav, it was not empty, it was not in vain. Anytime, Yisrael, we enter into the presence of Yisrael. That's why Shlomo says, give me the wisdom and the knowledge that I know how to go in and out before your people. Anytime we come before the people, don't do it in vain. Don't let the people go away empty. Make sure you give them substance. Make sure you give them meat that they can offer up the lectum offering unto Almighty Yah. Offering with the abundance of strength from their bosom that they can say, Torah, Yah. For that truth, Yisrael. He said, but even after that, we had suffered, we had endured before, we had suffered before we came and were shameful, intrigued. You did us wrong. You dishonored us. We were shamefully intrigued. Those that said they would embrace us, they did not. He says, as you know, at Philippi, we were bold in our Abba, Almighty Yah, 2 Thessalonica, yeah? Is that where I'm reading from? First, okay. 1 Thessalonica, yeah. 1 Thessalonica, yeah. I'm sorry, chapter 2. Toda Zachin Yarameya, Yisrael. All right, 1 Thessalonica, yeah, chapter 2. All right, we got it. 1 Thessalonica, yeah, chapter 2. Toda. He goes on to say, we were bold in verse 2, we were bold in our Abba to speak unto you the Bezorach, the message, the power of deliverance. He said, of Yah, he said, with much contention, with much and great battles. Because there were those that not would receive what we said. There was contention. There were accusations. They were speaking. They were talking under their breath. It was much contention. I don't mind contention. When we speak the truth with boldness, there's going to be contention. Contention not only those that fight us, but contention within your own life. As you resist, as you oppose, Yisrael. He said there was much contention. For our exhortation was not of deceit. Now we must understand that that is one of the most powerful elements of Hashatan, of deceit. Harach, harach, deceit, lies, and shechach, lies of deception. He said, we did not entertain you all with deceit. We not present a message and our lies were opposite of what we were teaching. He said, not with deceit. He says, nor of desertomy. It was not unclean. Our speech was not based upon pagan diadems and pagan ritualism. He said, not unclean. Nor in subtlety of guile. We did not come in the spirit of Hashatan. He said, but as we were granted, permitted, allowed of Almighty Yahweh. Did he say that? Am I reading that right? Maybe I'm reading it wrong. He said, but as we were allowed. So when someone is allowed a certain dispensation, they have been granted. There's permission. There has to be someone with a higher authority to permit them. You can't come in here. Okay. But I permit you to come in. So they grants them the ability to enter. He said, but as we were allowed of Yah to be nofand, to be put in trust. You tell me Yah trust Shaul? You tell me Yah had trust to Shaul and we don't even know those that are of Yah. He said, we were allowed of Yah to be trust, put in trust of this message. Even as we speak, not as pleasing men, not as promoting this self-gratification among men, not as one that seeks to soothe the conscience of men in their own ways. He said, but Yah, which tries our living. He said, Yah tries us to make sure that we're in standards of what he has commanded us to operate in. And that is the standard of the Torah, not speaking the Torah in shav, in vain, as though it is empty. He said, we've been put in trust of that, Yisrael. He said, neither for neither at any time did we use deceitful words, flattering speech. We did not say, oh, Zachin Yaramiya, that what you did, it was all right. No, you have sinned, man. You're a deceitful liar. No, Ahot Raphael, you are a Jezebel of a deceitful liar. You have taught the bath of Tizayon to rebel against their ish, and Jezebel in hell, you're going to lift your eyes. He said, we do not come with flattering words. Oh, she's sweet. No, she's not sweet. She's a damn liar. We do not come with words to entice and to relieve you. We came to make you free, to separate you. We did not come with flattering words as you, Yana. You know we did not, because that's why there was contempt and you were mad at us. He said, no, a cloak of this covetousness is greed. We were not covered with this air of greed and this cloak of self-righteousness. He said, Yah is our witness. Whether you have the vision to see that or not, Yah witness that that's not our nature. Yah is our witness. He said, we did not seek any honor from men. We did not seek their accolades or their speech to say, oh, look at Reach Daiwita. He's a fine man. No, tell everyone that I love money. And tell them that I'm a greedy dog. Tell them I'm a liar. Tell them I cheat. Tell them I rob. Tell them, well, you can't tell them I'm an adulteress because I know no woman for nearly 40 years, even before I married the woman, but this woman. So you can't tell them that, all right? All right, that will be a blatant lie. You know that. Tell them everything. Tell them I abuse the people. Tell them I cheat. Tell them I rob. Tell them I love money. I beg. I won't beg today, but you all that are sitting there. Do we have anyone listening? Simeon, come on. Come on. All right. Hallelujah. Come on. All right. There's enough households that everyone send an offering. All right. Send an offering. Send an offering to Yah. Hallelujah. He said, neither we sought the prestige of men, neither of you. He said, I'm talking to you as well. I did not seek your permission, did not seek your counsel, did not seek your approval at all. He said, nor yet of others, when we might have been burdensome as the Shulisham of Yahshua HaMashiach. He said, but we were gentle among you, even as a nurse cherishing her child. Well, you're not gentle. Can I ask you a question? I just watched that mother. Are those children you all have? Do you nourish them? You sure now? Those your children? You sure? You make sure they're nourished?
I saw you go out a few minutes ago and you had that little thing. If I had caught you, I would have stopped you. Did you nourish them? Were you gentle? Yeah, you were gentle. You didn't. Can I see your face, Ahava? Shalom. Say shalom. Can I see you, Hadassah? Hey, they're still alive. They have life in them. They're blushing. See, we're such an ignorant people because, but you were harsh though, weren't you? Yeah, you were. Frustrated, I told you to stop and stop. And Joel took that rod and I put it on your buttock. See, we don't think that, yeah, his rod of correction, we don't like that. So when a man used that, he's not gentle. Oh, I'm gentle, Yisrael. Hallelujah. How the language has construed us. Is Yah gentle? Isn't that one of the ruachem of the ruach of Yah? He's going to send us a delusion, but he's gentle? Sure he is. The enemy has dumbed us down and made us silly and stupid, Yisrael. That is the whole protocol of this beast mind, to turn you away from the simplicity of Yah's truth. He says, so being affectionately desirous of you, our compassion was to teach you truth and to bring out the hidden mysteries of Yah. He said, we were willing to have imparted unto you not only the Torah or the truth of our Abaya, only, but also our nefesh. We were willing to give up our lives because you were dear unto us. Because you're in my heart. Because I care for you. Because I love you. And even though all have forsaken us and turned against us, I know that when this knowledge comes to light in your heart, you will understand. That's the whole purpose. There's no other reason for me. For you remember, brethren, or our labor. You remember how we worked? He said, how our travail, how the battles and the tremendous agony. You remember that. You remember how we've travailed. And laboring, he said, night and day. Sometimes we don't see the messenger as he labors night and day. We don't see how he labors in Torah. We don't see how he labors to make sure. I was telling Ach Simeon and my Ach Shimri yesterday, look, man, there's only one thing. Let's get this done. Let's get that done. We must get that done. And of course, I said to Shimri, I said, I can't burden Simeon down with less. I said, no, I'll go over there and look for that, all right? We must get this done. We got to get that done. We got to get this done. The most important thing is that we get the seed in the ground. Y'all must get the seed in the ground. Everything must be on time. So labor in those aspects, not only in the spiritual, but the natural as well. We don't give a damn. We lay on our ass and sleep and follow. The matter of strength, his mind is on that. And he ponders, he talks about, come on. Come on, Ak. Reak, what about this? We gonna get this done? He looks, he observes. I will, man. Shaul looked over the house of Yah. Just like, that's why we shall earn our living by the sweat of our face. And that's why messengers and men of Yah, we should look at everything. Look at the raised bed, all right. Okay, need fertilizing there. Don't need no one to tell you to fertilize them, just fertilize them. You know? But that's not the conscience of this generation. It doesn't give a damn. Shaul said, we labor night and day. We cared for you. When you are asleep, I'm awake. I said to my Ach, I talk, you know, Shimri and I, we're together because we have some of the same passions. You know, we like to do some of the same things. You said, but yeah, when they're in here, or I said, Doc, when he's around, we like to do some of the same things, you understand? And I'm very liberal in my conversation with my Ach. I don't hold nothing back. I tell them. You know, if you were around, I would tell you. You're just not around. You don't like to do the things they do, and they like doing things I like doing. But I'm very liberal. And I just talk. And I told them, I don't hold nothing back from them. No, I'm not going to wait for the council of the elders to tell them and sit down. No. We all are valuable. We all are the same. You understand? I told him, I wish I had him in here with me, him or him, one of them, either you. But I know we have to take care of that. You understand?
He says, for you remember, brothers, verse 9, our labor and our travail. And see, Yah's giving them a witness for laboring night and day, because we will not be chargeable unto any of you. We preach unto you the message of Almighty Yah. You're not going to say that you didn't tell me that. You did not tell me the truth. Or I gave you $10 and you held back. You didn't speak flattery things to me. You're not going to tell me that. You're not going to say that. Well, I gave money there and you did not mind. There are folks that left from here. They came with nothing, bone dry. And they left, all of them left with U-Hauls. Every last one of them, they left carrying. When this man in that plaid suit there, when this man here came here, he was a young lad. He came with a brown bag. He had some clothes in that. He came with two or three fishing rods. One was broke. He came with a tackle box. He didn't come with a damn thing. And look how, come on, Yisrael. And Ishaw, two babies, come on. He couldn't leave here with that same brown bag he brought in, that little same little tackle box. Come on, Yisrael. And these dirty bastards, you understand? Shaul said, I was not chargeable unto any of you all. I was not chargeable unto you. I could have gave every last one of them 20,000. They still would have lashed out like dirty dogs. You understand? Because a dog, a beast. I was watching the two big rock wallers yesterday. I said, no, let them roll, man. Don't come on. Well, he is a beast. That's a dog, man. Big dog. I like to have one that big, even bigger. I like big dogs. I want one that I can kick in the head and say, come get me, boy. And so he was out yesterday, and he was happy to be free a little bit. He was smelling himself. And when they get together, they do a little rocking. You understand? They like the ball. As we like the ball, they like the ball. I said, man, don't. Let him. They're dogs. I want to see him work himself a little bit. Let him. Yeah, that's what I like. Let him work him a little bit. They run and go, yeah, let him work. Yeah, I like to see him work a little bit. That's what they're for. That's what a male dog is for. Come on. He established his preeminence, his power. You don't let them do that. Something is wrong. You make them a wussy of a dog. Let him out. Let him hook up. Nice to have two male dogs. And a female, he wouldn't have done a thing. Male dog. Let them hook up a little bit. They'll be all right. Get the training skills. Their milkhaya, the military power. So can you help me? Let them fight a little bit. Don't let them kill each other. Let them fight. That's what they're for. Hallelujah. So he's ready when the stranger dog comes in. And the stranger, he'll put a work on the stranger dog. If you know what I mean. The dogs. All right. I want to close in a minute. Hallelujah. He said, you are witnesses, and Yah also, not only have you seen, but Yah, he is a witness, how kadosh and just and unblameable we have behaved ourselves among you that believe. We have not taken your monies. You know, it's amazing. I say this, that people don't see where the little funds that we have had, where they have gone. They have gone into this place. I don't live rich. I don't have no monies, nothing, no savings or anything. You understand? But I have truth, and that's all that matters to me. I have Yahshua HaMashiach. He said, we have labored among you, verse 11, and you know how we exhorted and comforted and charged every one of you as a father does his children, that you should walk worthy of Yah. And I would charge you that. I don't care if you don't like me. You're going to have to walk worthy of the callings of Almighty Yah and Yahshua. You must walk worthy that he can look down and say, this is my beloved, I am well pleased in, my son, my daughter, my children. You must walk worthy of this vocation. And you can walk worthy of this vocation, doing the things that are offense unto him. And the damn Christmas and the pagan holy days are an offense unto Yah. And I'm not going to sugarcoat that. I'm not going to speak favorably toward those things. Damn them, they're wrong, they're pagan. They are the shrines of darkness. He says, you should walk worthy of Yah's vocation, that you may walk worthy of Yah, who have called you unto his kingdom and his splendor. Don't you know we got to present what he commands? He has called you Yisra'iyah. He has kara. Come on. Down through the channels of time, down through the ages, he called out in the beginning. He says, mama's going to name him Earl Rainey, but wake up Earl Rainey, my boy. That's how he did it. Josh Miller, wake up, son. He has called you to his kingdom. He has bidden you the invitation. Have no mind do that. He is the one that called. He is the one that bid it. And not only that, but you'll be draped in his splendid, his honor, his beauty, not in this damn pagan mess. They put on the damn satanic suits. Come on, talk to me. He is the one that called us to his splendid, his kingdom and his honor. Get up out of darkness, he called us. Hallelujah. He said, for just knowing that, for this reason, for this cause, also we give toda unto Yah. How? Without ceasing. Toda, toda, Yahweh, toda, toda, Yah. Oh, toda, toda, Yahweh, toda, toda, Yah. Toda, toda, Yahweh, toda, Yahweh. I want a toda, Yah, for another day. They sing it. Oh, toda, toda, Yahweh, toda, toda, Yah, toda, toda, Yahweh, toda, toda, Yah. Oh, toda, toda, Yahweh, toda, Yahweh. Turaya for ya, sure. We used to sing that. We would sing that song for 30 minutes. Come on, mama. Oh, we sang a little different. Thank you, Yahshua. Blessed be your name. Oh, thank you, Yahshua. Blessed be your name. Oh. Thank you, Yahshua, blessed be your name. I want to thank you, Yahshua, for another day. Thank you, Yahshua. Oh, we used to sing it like that. By the time the preacher came along, you would go out. Let's sing a song like that for an hour. And don't have no music accommodating it. Don't have nobody on the drums. And don't have nobody on the keyboard. Because the drum boy, he's going to boy just almost I'm getting in his arm. He's just going to play. And the keyboard, he's going to roll all night long. We sing a song for 1 hour straight. Hallelujah. See, for this cause, we get Torah to Yah without ceasing, because when you receive the Torah of Yah, which you heard of us, that's how you receive, you've heard. You heard it of Yah's messengers. You receive it not as word of man. That's the problem with people today. Well, no man tell me now, when you hear the truth, when you hear it, it makes you free. You're not receiving it as from the word of a man, but as it is in truth. It is from the Torah, the principles of Torah, the word of Yah, which effectually worketh also in you that believe. It must work effectively in us if we believe. That's the only way. If we don't believe, it's not going to have its effectual workings in us, Yisra'iyah. That's what we can partake with these damn pagans, the Christmas, the Hog Day, Thanksgiving, the Halloween. We give out a little candy. Where are they going to come? No. I'm glad they think of us what they think of us down here. We don't have to worry about them coming down in here. We don't have to worry about that. Matter of fact, we lock the gates anyway. But we don't have to worry about that. Never had no problem with that. None of that. We had the Jehovah's Witnesses come one time, and after that, when they met me, they haven't been back. Or they put a marker here, that put an X there. Don't go there. I don't give a damn who they are. I didn't even let those individuals, the census workers, say, no, hold on, no. Don't worry about what's back there. You don't come here like that. You leave it with me. Nah, you don't do that here. A little Jezebel down here, come here dressed like a dirty slut. So you're not coming here like that. No. Got young men. I'm not going to even let you rouse them like that. They have enough out there. You think, nah. From house to house, you sit down? Nah. You can't do that here, woman. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Quickly. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Where did I stop? Verse 14. For brothers, for you brothers, become followers of the assembly of Yah, which is in Yehuda, in Yahushua HaMashiach. For you also have suffered like things of your own countrymen, even as you have of the Yehudim, who both the Yehudim, our countrymen Yisrael, who both killed Yahushua HaMashiach for their and their own prophets, and have persecuted us, that they please not Yah, and are contrary to all men, forbidding us to speak to the nations of the world. Because Yisrael is found among the nations, that they might be your shaksei, to fill up their sins always, for the wrath is come upon them to the uttermost. Hallelujah. But we are being taken from you for a short time in presence, not in heart, endeavors the more abundantly to see your face with great desire. That's the heart of Yisrael. Yeah, that's the heart of Yah. He wants to see our face. That's why the Shabbat is a beautiful thing. That's why he will not give us to the delusions of darkness. Wherefore, we would have come unto you, even I, Shaul, and once again, but who hindered him? Hashatan. So that's what hinders the labor of Yah's messengers today. Yah have sent the delusions, the strong ones. He said, but Shatan hindered us. For what is our tikvah? What is our shimcha? What is our crown, our kita of rejoicing? Are not even you in the presence of Yah, in the presence of Yahushua HaMashiach at his coming? For you are the splendor of our joy. Isn't that the splendor of every messenger when he labors, when he brings unto us? Is to see, isn't that the splendor of Yah? To see our joy in the face when Yahushua coming. Let me close with this last one here from 2 Thessalonians 2 and 11. 2 Thessalonians, that's where I intended to from the beginning. Hallelujah. Well, that's all right, but that was tough too. He says here, for the mystery, 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 7. He says, for the mysteries of iniquity of Ovon doth already work. Where those iniquity is a mind that is total lessness. It has not the power of Torah or the discipline of Torah. Only he who now lets, or the messenger of Yah, Mikhayah, the melach that guards Yisrael, he is the one that lets. See, Yah is the one that is letting what is happening. He is the one that is permitting it. He that who lets until he be taken out of the way, until he is removed, till he is held back. He said, and then shall the wicked one or the wicked be revealed. He shall be made known, whom Yahushua shall consume with the ruach of his mouth and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming. He tell us, did not Shaul say, even Hashatan hinder us? And that is the hindrance of Yisrael. He says here, even him whose coming is after the working of Hashatan with all power. He says he's coming with all power, with all rab, with a great extent of authority, rab. He said, well, also with signs, not the more faith, but I like to see me on, or the Greek word in this, with signs. And he calls them lying wonders, does he not? He called them lying wonders. Someone wrote me the other day, do you cast out demons by the power of the Holy Ghost? Damn the Holy Ghost. You're not casting out a damn thing, man. They want that today. They want every time you go cast a demon, damn stupidity. And casting out nothing in the name of your pagan Jesus. He said he's coming with all deceit in verse 10 of wickedness. Christmas is wicked. Thanksgiving all in them that perish because they receive not the love of the Torah. This is we must receive the love of Torah. They receive not. That's what Yeshua was speaking to Yisrael. Yah said, bring a lamb and you bring a damn dog's neck. He said, bring an oblation. You smeared in pig's blood. You stinking pigs. That they might be Yahshak saved. He said, for this cause, look, Yah shall send them strong delusion that they should believe a lie. That's what he's doing. People are believing this lie of Christmas. Are they not? 71% of them say Saint Nick is the reason. That's why we are the Kedoshim. We're not the saints. We're the Kedoshim. the Kirushim, the elect of Yah, with the Kirushim, with the Mashiach, not a damn saint, all right? Hallelujah. For this cause, Yah shall send them strong delusion, that they should believe a lie, that they all might be damned. Now, Yah said that he's going to damn them. So I use the word damn, 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 damn. He said that they all might be damned, while who believe not the truth, but they had pleasure. Did he not say you have pleasure in your own ways? Would have pleasure in unrighteousness. But we are bound, we are commanded to give Torah always to Yah, for you, my Ach Yisrael, beloved of Yahshua, because Yah have from the beginning chosen you. I'm glad Mama didn't choose me. Yah from the beginning has chosen me. Not Daddy, Mama. Yah has. Yah from the beginning. He's not going to allow us to be taken by the delusion. From the beginning has chosen you to your sure salvation through the set apartness or chadosh, sanctification of the Ruach, and above all, and belief of what? Of the truth, not truth, but the truth of the Torah. So that's how he set you apart, because you believe the Torah Yisrael. I'm going to abruptly stop right there, period. I will get back on the course, all right. I needed that for those that are listening. Those that are new, there are always people. Believe me, there are people online that have never listened. They come, they have never heard. They have heard, and then they come to hear. And so, because we believe the truth, that's the most vital, important thing. Because Yahshua lives, we can face tomorrow. May Yah rock you all, Yisrael. May he strengthen you, the elect of Yah, the chosen. From the beginning, he has chosen you. That's why it wasn't your mother's prayers. It's wonderful mother prayed to give her discipline. But it wasn't the wife's prayer, the husband's prayer. It was Yah. He had already made the decision. That little dirty thing she's going to name David Roberts, he's the dirty vow thing. When the sons of Yah went to present themselves unto Yah came, here come Hashatan. And for that time was even, there's no day and night with Yah. You understand? The Malach says, he said to the Malach, David Roberts, 1955, June 6th, Hickory, South Carolina. What is Hickory? But the Malach knew. And he stood there. Nothing there, Baron. I got to be here to protect him. And out, boom, out of Bithynia. Our name is, that was my mother's name, Bithynia. Hallelujah. Was birthed this child. Hallelujah. He was birthed. The doctors were so unconcerned. They say he was born on this date. He was born 2 weeks before then. Because every woman knows when the child comes forth. It's amazing that when I got my passport, when I renewed my passport, a young man, I can tell he was from South America. Love America, but what about America? It's more than just North America. South America. It's Brazil, it's Chile. Oh, that's America. These are wicked people in this country. I love America. I want my country back. Isn't that amazing? They just want the country back since they got a half breed up there in the White House. I say it that way. Mr. Obama, come on. I'm not going to disown him because he is my president. I will do that. I'm not going to go out here and march on the White House. I ain't marching nothing. I ain't going to vote for him. He's my president. He is Mr. Barack Hussein Obama. He is the president of the United States. I will never tell no one to pick up arms. I don't even really, we shouldn't even just talk against the king. That's the truth. You shouldn't say anything against him. Leave him alone. Yah put him there. So I leave you alone, Mr. Obama. I ain't messing with you. Hallelujah. 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 And the Malach said, I got the guard until that day, and out come this child, and the seal was put there. The seal was placed there. So it wasn't mama's prayers that delivered you. It wasn't daddy's prayer. Baby, I prayed for you all for 30 years. Mama, you didn't even pray for you. Stop that, mama. Stop that mess. He has chosen you. He has elected you from the beginning. He has called you before the foundation of the world, man. Isn't that beautiful? I like that. If I take nothing else today, the market, we'll finish. We'll get it right. May Yah rich you all, your friends, be strengthened today. We do receive your gifts to help, to assist. And also for the live stream, it's beautiful now. You don't have all the all the interference with commercials. So click on that button there and send an offering just for that. Send it for that, all right? Send an offering, but send an offering for that, all right? It's all right. You can send 10 to assist and to help and 10 for that, all right? Send $20, send $50. Come on, Israel. It's a sad shame. There are folks that have gone in so much debt, it'll take them 3 years to pay it out. And you can send an offering. Every now and then I say, send an offering to help us. There are some that are very faithful. I appreciate you. But send an offering. Come on. Send an offering to help us here. We live in Yahshua HaMashiach. I'm glad to be alive, Yisrael. I'm happy. I'm broke. As a skunk. May Yaburak you. Let us stand to our feet. Hallelujah. And by the way, his name is Yahweh. We call him Yah. His name is Yahweh. All right. And his son's name is Yahshua HaMashiach. Let us turn to Yerushalayim. Hallelujah. In all things we do, Barak you, Yah. For your kindness, your mercy, your tenderness in Yahshua's name. We ask you to Barak Yisrael, to touch us all and to strengthen us. That we'll be strong and guard the minds of your people on this celebration. It's not celebratory, this pagan exaltation. Guard them all and keep them in the love of Yahshua HaMashiach. As we shall take solace and comfort in your Torah this Shabbat, we barak you for all things. Grant unto your people safety, our Ach, our Zachin Shimri, as he travel with his Isha, and our Ima Yunus as they travel the highway, our whole Jennifer and our whole plant and her family. Protect them in Yahshua's mighty name and keep them guarded from this devious power of hell. And all of us, we need it as much as any man. We ask all things in Yahshua's name. Protect all Yisrael, Yah, scattered abroad. We pray for the shalom of Yerushalayim as we bless your city, Yah. We ask all things in Yahshua's name. And our hearts being filled today, we shout hallelujah. 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 Amen. Yabarak.